up, everybody? Pal 702. Back today with another regulated mod review. What the fuck? All right, so today we have the Augvape VX200 regulated mod. It's a dual 18650. Now, I know you guys have seen this. This has been reviewed a million times. But you also know the pact that I made with you guys. We don't do sub-ohm tanks here, man. We don't do pods here. Everyone else does that. That's cool. I have nothing against them. Just not my thing. But Augvape was kind enough to send me a mod and then an RTA to build on top. Let me just make one thing clear. When it comes to my wicking on an RTA, as of now, I would highly suggest don't do as I do. Do better, okay? I just wick it so it doesn't dry hit and it does not give me devil's cum spit back down my throat and do 5 milliliters in like 5 rips. So, you can leave comments below though on how well I do or how bad I suck. That being said, what we do right about now, we're gonna go downtown. I'm gonna show you all around this VX200. We are gonna build an RTA. We're gonna make good on that New Year's resolution. Got something funky for you to listen to. And we're gonna pop back up. Pros and cons. You know how we do it. All right, today it is the Augvape VX200 dual 18650 regulated mod. On front, you see you have VX200, the VX200 box mod, 200 watts, and it is a black one. They come in a couple different finishes, but this is black on black. There'll be nothing really on the box worth showing you, so we're just gonna dig in. All right, upon opening your VX200, you will get a user manual, a VX200 mod, and a USB cable for firmware updates, not for charging. Thank you very much. Quick look at the manual. We're just gonna look for what is important. When I go through all these manuals and shit like that, like I'm gonna show you how to put this thing together, but the specifications are something I like to go over. And just a couple things to point out. This thing will fire down to a 0.05, which is very nice, up to 200 watts, and has a maximum of a 40 amp output. And this right here, normally I don't really point out weight, but 65 grams. This thing is so light that it's either just gonna shatter to pieces when you drop it, or it's gonna just like a feather, just like not even touch the ground. Your USB cable for firmware updates. All right, so here it is. This is the VX200 by Augvape dual 18650 regulated mod. Now, one thing this is supposed to look like is a cell phone. It's basically supposed to look like that right there. It's supposed to have like the rounded edges, like the S8 or S25X or whatever the new one is. But this is what inspired this. Everybody loves their cell phones, right? So why not make a mod that looks like a cell phone? All right, so if you see now up front, it has a very, very heavily tinted screen. You'll see, you know, your up and down buttons right here, which we'll go over further once we put some batteries in here. You have your USB port right there. Up top now, you will have a centered spring-loaded 510 pin. Yep, definitely spring-loaded right there. Looks like it is a gold-plated 510 and probably like some type of stainless steel 510 assembly right here. Now across the bottom, you will see right up top here, you're gonna have ventilation holes right here, and it says designed by Augvape. And one thing that I was pleasantly surprised is to see that there was no spring hinge door on the bottom. There'll be none of that. As a matter of fact, on the back here, you have a door. This right here is your battery door. This is the inside of it. You can see it is a smoked plastic door, and you have magnets on both ends right here. Definitely a fingerprint magnet. So if this review looks, if this thing looks all fingerprinted out and dirty and smudgy, I promise you I washed the shit out of this thing before the review. But as soon as you touch it, you're getting fingerprints on it. Now, both of those magnets on the door, they will contact there. Look at that, nice heavy magnet. And there. Now, in your actual battery tray itself, you will see positive up, negative down, positive down, negative up. It is in a series configuration, as are most regulated mods. And you also have A and B right here, so you know which battery is displaying on the display once we get to that part. You know, you have your battery contacts here. These bottom guys do not have any type of spring. Well, no, they got a little spring to them. I take that back. It's got a little spring. Stiff spring, but a little bit of spring. And all these contacts are just, they appear to be gold plated. And you have your little strap right there. So if you are a fan of that, then congratulations. And if you do not care, then you could just cut that bad boy straight out. All right, so batteries. It is a regulated mod, so I don't have to run 30 amp mechanical beast in here. I can just kick back and run these E-Fest, which I never ever get a chance to run because basically it's always mechanical. So these guys right here, positive up, positive down, and your door. All right, so here is the display right here. Now, I have this thing cranked all the way up and I have messed with the lights as much as possible. This is not going to be easy to see, but white is the best color. So, as you can see though, the display itself is actually fairly large. Right here in the middle, 75 watts. You have your mode right there, your hit mode, normal. You have your A and your B batteries, which looks like I need to change it. But since this is a regulated mod, right? I need to keep running this thing until it says low battery. You have your ohms right there, your applied voltage right there. And then as you hit this thing, well, it's not gonna do it, but this right here is like a speedometer style timer. So it'll just go 1, 2, 3, 4. It'll just tell you like how long each hit was. Now down there, once again, firmware updates. You have your up and your down. Let's see how fast this thing goes. Pretty fast. Ooh. Round robin. Starts all the way from the bottom. Nice. All right, so get into your menu, very simple, three clicks. 1, 2, 3. Now you'll see in this menu right here, you have variable wattage, temperature control, variable voltage, which is my favorite. You have a bypass, settings, and information. So we'll just start picking stuff like information. You can go into stats. You know, it's gonna give you your puff counts, 364, average time, all that stuff like that. Bypass mode, which is gonna run this thing very similar to a mechanical mod. Variable voltage mode right there, so you can adjust your voltage all the way up to 7.2. So you do have a pretty decent voltage on this right here. Okay, let's put this back. Temperature control. All the usual suspects right there. Variable wattage. When you go in there, you can pick normal, soft, hard, all that stuff like that. Kind of like the preheat or boost when you hit the fire button. And also settings. You can do a ton of different shit, but I'm just gonna show you, like, you can change the colors in here, and then you can actually go to user defined, and then you literally can mix all these colors to come up with your own color. The only reason I don't mess with this is because white is about the only color that you're ever really gonna see. Everything else is just, it's, the screen is very dark and very fingerprinty. And then five clicks on and off. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It says bye. Very polite. All right, so what will fit on top of this thing right here? You know, I do love that, you know, I've got a couple mods from these guys and they always center their 510s, which is awesome. We will go with the Sherman 28mm. 28mm sits flush. There is no overhang. Yeah, no overhang at all. So you can run all the way up to a 28mm on this tiny little mod, which is the reason why when people put the 510 in the center, they're awesome. All right, so that is it on the Augvape VX200 regulated mod. Now, like I said, these come typically in the kit. There's a starter kit and it comes with a bunch of disposable sub-ohm tanks. There's a, pretty much everyone that's reviewed this has reviewed the tanks. We don't do sub-ohms around here, but Augvape was nice enough to send this here intake RTA to get me started on my New Year's resolution of building and enjoying tanks minus dry hits. Hit it.
Diggy, he got something to say.
I like him brown, yellow, Puerto Rican, or Haitian. Name is Fight Dog from the Zulu Nation. Told you in the jam that we could get down. Now let's knock the boots like the group H-Town. You got BBD all on your bedroom wall. But I'm above the rim and this is how I ball. A gritty little something on the New York street. This is how I represent over this here beat. Talking about you.
Yo, I took you out. But sex was on my mind for the whole damn route. My mind was in a frenzy in a horny state. But I couldn't drop dimes cause you couldn't relate. You couldn't relate. You couldn't relate. Stretch out your legs, let me make it ball. Drive you insane, drive you up the wall. Staring at your dome piece, very strong. Stronger than pride, stronger than Teflon. Take it on the Ave and you buy me links. Now I run a pound of Poontang until it stinks. You could be my mama and I'll be your boy.
Original road boy, never am I coy. You could be a shorty in my ill convoy. Not to come across as a thug or a hood. What? But hun, you got the goods like Madeline Wood. By the way, my name's Malik, the 5 foot freak. They say we get together by the end of the week. She simply said no, label me a hoe.
And that was a little Tribe Called Quest. I mean, the golden age of rap, hip hop, where to go? Fuck mama rap, all right? That's all I'm saying. We're not here for that though. We're here for the Augvape VX200 regulated dual 18650 mod. We have the Mikey motherfucking vapes intake sitting on top, a little bit of taffy splash inside there, and a pretty nice wick job for me. Let's take it for a rip. Oh yeah, 55 watts. No dry hit. All right, so we're gonna do right about now. We're gonna do pros and cons. Start off with the cons, and on the pros, because around here, believe it or not, we always end on a positive note. Cons on the VX200 by Augvape. Two cons, fingerprint magnet, and they tinted the shit out of the screen. So when you're outside, you're really not gonna be able to see anything. I mean, if you put it on the white, I mean, I don't even know if you can see the white from here. I don't know if you can see it. I mean, we have four studio lights on. But you get out in the sunlight, you're probably not gonna see this thing. So, I mean, I get it, like, tinting a screen is nice, but try reviewing this fucking thing. It's impossible. Like, between the fingerprints and how shiny it is, I don't know how many times it's gonna go out of focus, but we, like, seriously tried as hard as we could. As hard as we could. But those are my own two cons, you know? It's gonna be screen's too dark, fingerprint magnet, and just a FYI, this mod right here is so light. So if you're someone that's into 3D printed mods, or you love super light mods, then that's not gonna be an issue for you. If you're someone that likes something, you know, with a little bit of girth to it, a little bit of weight, you know, it's just really light. All right, so pros on the VX200. This is the second mod that Augvape sent me, and there's four things that they have done on this mod and the Druga Foxy that I fucking love. Variable voltage, first of all, for mechanical love, just showing the mechanical vapors love. Sometimes we don't know wattage. We could figure it out with Ohm's law, but we know volts and we know resistance. So it's nice that they've done this on the last two mods that I got. Next pro is going to be the fact, no hinge door. Look at that, beautiful, simple. You don't have to ever worry about like the hinge getting jacked up or anything like that. Very simple. I love the fact they use battery doors. Next pro, centered 510 pin. This mod itself, I mean, the tank's big, but the mod itself, I mean, the mod is tiny, yet it can hold up to a fucking 28, which is a massive pro. And final pro is gonna be the fact that, once again, the chip fires down to a 0.05, which that's not necessarily important for me as far as the style that I vape. I don't vape 0.05, but sometimes when you're building with stainless steel and stuff like that, it'll dip. Like if you're building a 0.1 or 1.1, sometimes it'll dip, you know, north of a 0.07 just for a second. Massive pro though. And actually a final pro on just the overall, like the display. I mean, it has your ohms, which I had a 0.43 in here. It has your A and your B battery, which is listed on the back, so you know which battery you're even looking at. Applied voltage, which right now I'm doing about 5 volts. So the menu setup and stuff like that, and also it's just extremely basic. It's easy to navigate, and it's got like the side fire switch right here, which I don't think I actually covered that down below, but the switch is on the side. It's this entire bar, kind of reminiscent of the, everybody had one, the smoke alien back in the day, that little side bar right there. Very clicky though, nice. I just turned it off. All right, so price. What will the Augvape VX200 regulated mod cost you? This guy got it for $3.93. Shout out to Augvape. Thank you for sending it. I'm not talking about the kit. I'm talking about the mod itself. I've seen this thing anywhere from the high 20s to the mid 30s. So, I mean, people spend more than that on drip tips. So if you are into super, super light ass mods, you don't want the bottom flap, you like battery doors, you like centered 510 pins, you like 0.05, you like all that shit, then you might want to check it out. I'll leave a link right here to Augvape, even though just use your Google Foo, but since they sent it, I'm just gonna leave a link right here. And that is it. That is all that I have for you on the Augvape VX200 regulated mod. And I wicked an RTA and haven't got a dry hit yet. All right, so massive shout out to you guys for all of the fucking awesome comments you're gonna leave me on my RTA build. Or all the comments how you think I lost my damn mind because I did a regulated mod with a RTA on top. But you know what? You gotta be flexible. It's time to do tanks, man. I took not sub-ohm tanks, RTAs. I took 3 or 4 years off. They've gotten much better. I have to definitely acknowledge that. But around here, with my regulated RTA setup, it's a totally new experience, but it is still all love, and I will catch you guys on Monday.